Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Operations Research. This is lecture number 11 in Linear Programming Problem. We are going to discuss integer programming. In the integer programming, we are going to take the cutting plane algorithm and we will be solving problem in the cutting plane algorithm. In the earlier lectures in the linear programming problem, we discussed the graphical method, simplex method, big M method, two-phase method, dual simplex method. In all the problems, the decision variables are positive, that is non-negative. But the value may be in fractions also, like 1.1, 1.8, 2.5. So the value will be not integer, but positive values. But here, for certain problem, we require integer values. The decision value should be non-negative, at the same time, it should be integer. So, such a problem are solved by integer programming techniques. So, there are cutting plane algorithm and branch and bound algorithm for solving the integer programming problem. So, we will discuss in this lecture cutting plane algorithm, and in the next lecture, we discuss the branch and bound technique. So, at the end of the lecture, the learning outcome to the students, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problem in integer programming using the cutting plane algorithm. Integer programming is a type of linear programming problem in which the decision variables take integers or discrete values. So, in all the problems, all the LPP, the decision variables are positive, but here, we require integer values. There are two types of integer programming problem, pure integer programming problem and the mixed integer programming problem. In pure integer programming problem, all the decision variables are restricted to integers. In the mixed integer programming problem, only few decision variables are restricted to integer and all the variables are positive. There is one simple technique to address the integer programming problem is linear programming relaxation method. So, solve the problem by regular simplex method or regular linear programming method and then round off the decision variables to the next integer. That is one technique. But it is an approximate technique. So, it is called as a relaxation method. For a simple solution, numerical solution, we can use the methodology. But for decision making, in a business environment, competitive business environment, we cannot use this method. In the competitive business environment, we require accurate results. So, in that method, we have to go for a specific integer programming algorithm. So, there are two methods. The methods available to solve the integer programming problems are cutting plane algorithm and branch and bound algorithm. And in this lecture, we will be solving problem in cutting plane algorithm to understand the methodology. So, maximize z equal to x1 plus x2 subject to the constraint 2x1 plus 5x2 less than or equal to 20, 6x1 plus 4x2 less than or equal to 28, x1, x2 are greater than equal to 0 and integers. So, the non-negative at the same time they are integers. So, the first step we have to standardize the integer programming problem, IPP. So, maximize z minus x1 minus x2 minus 0 s1 minus 0 s2. Rearranging the terms, substituting the slack variables. So, you will get maximize z minus x1 minus x2 minus 0 s1 minus 0 s2 subject to the constraints 2x1 plus 5x2 plus s1 equal to 0, 6x1 plus 4x2 plus s2 equal to 28, where x1, x2 are greater than or equal to 0 and integers, s1, s2 are greater than or equal to 0. So, the slack variables need not be integer. So, they are just greater than 0. So, the basic solution is given here. So, in the basic solution, we go to the, this is the first iteration, we go to the second iteration. For the second iteration, we have to identify the entering variable and leaving variable. So, here x1 has got the least value, both x1 and x2, they have the same value minus 1, we take x1 as the entering variable and the intercept, looking at the intercept, So the lowest intercept is S2, 4 value for S2. So S2 is the leaving row, leaving variable, and the pivot number is 6. So in the second, so this is entering variable and leaving variable, and the pivot row, new pivot row is X1 row, which is current pivot row divided by the pivot number. New Z row equal to current Z row minus of minus 1 into new pivot row. New S1 row equal to current S1 row minus of 2 into new pivot row. So using the equations, solving the problem, the answer is shown here. So now the answer Z row 10 minus of 0.33, 0.17, 4.67. The answer is 4.67. S1 row 00 3.67, 1 minus of 0.33, 10.67. X1 row 01 0.67, 0.17, 4.67. Now the solution is not optimum because X2, it has got the negative value. Now X2 is the entering variable, and the leaving variable is S1 with 10.67 divided by 3.67 is the intercept. And here the entering variable is X2 with the least coefficient Z equation, leaving variable is S1 with the least intercept, and the pivot number is 3.67. The solution equation for the third iteration, new pivot row X2 row equal to current pivot row S1 row divided by the pivot number, new Z row equal to current Z row minus of minus 0.33 into new pivot row. And the new X1 row equal to current X1 row minus of 0.67 into new pivot row. Using the three equations, solving the table, the solution for the third iteration, it is here. So the basic equation, now you look at here, Z equal to 5.64, X2 equal to 2.91, X1 equal to 2.73, and X1, X2 values take 0. So the solution is optimum, but the decision variables are not integer. So the solution is optimum, but we have to integerize the answer, integerize the decision variable. For integerizing, we use the cutting plane algorithm. So the solution X1 equal to 2.73 and X2 equal to 2.91. So fraction of the value of the variable 0.73 and 0.91. So in the X1 value 0.73 and the X2 variable 0.91. Among the value, the highest value is 0.91. Now, first we apply the cutting plane technique for the X2 variable. So, the fractional cut is given to the variable X2. So, the equation X2 plus 0.27 S1 minus 0.09 S2 equal to 2.91. So, this equation we may also write like this, X2 plus 0.27 S1 minus 0 plus 0.09 S2 equal to 2 plus 0.91. Now, the fractional cut is given by the new constant equation, 0.27 S1 plus 0.09 S2 plus S3 equal to minus 0.91. Now, introduce the constant equation, the solution, and the equation will be like this. So, the three rows, they have the same value. The third row is inserted here. S3 equal to 0, 0, 0, minus 0.27, 0.09, 1, minus 0.91. Now, in the solution column, we have a negative value. Now, we have to solve it by dual simplex method. So, the leaving variable, first we have to identify the leaving variable, which is S3 with a negative coefficient, and the entering variable is S1. So, the pivot number is minus of 0.27. Now, the entering variable is S1, leaving variable is 0.91, and the equations to solve the problem, new pivot row, which is S1 row equal to current pivot row, S3 row, divided by the pivot number, which is minus of 0.27, new Z row equal to current Z row, minus of 0.09 into new pivot row, new X2 row equal to current X2 row, minus of 0.27 into new pivot row, and new X1 row equal to current X1 row minus of minus 0.18 into new pivot row. So, using the four equations, calculating this, finding the solution for the fourth iteration, the solution, it is like this. Say Z row 10, 00, 0.17, 0.33, 5.34, x2 row 0 0 1 0 0 1 2, x1 row 0 1 0 0 0.17 minus 0.67 3.34, and s1 row 0 0 0 s1 minus of 0.33 minus 3.7 3.37. Now once again here look at the solution, the 3.34, x1 equal to 3.34. So now the equation x1 equal to 3.34, which is again not integer. So a fractional cut is given to the value to the variable x1. Now the x1 equation, it is like this. So x1 plus 0.17 s2 plus 0.67 s3. So x1 equal to 3.34. So x1, this x1 plus 0.17 s2 minus 0.67 s3 equal to 3.34, and the equation we can also write like this: x1 plus 0 plus 0.17 s2 minus of 0 plus 0.67 s3 equal to 3.34. Now the fractional cut is given in the equation: minus of 0.17 s2 plus of 0.067 s3 plus s4 equal to minus of 0.34. We subtract minus 0.34. Now introduce the new constraint in the equation. In the solution. So, we have the table, we introduce the table, the value here. So, the first four rows, the same values. The fifth row, we are adding S4 equal to 0, 0, 0, 0, minus 0.17, 0.67, and S4 equal to 1, and the solution is minus of 0.34. Now, again, solve the fifth iteration, again use the dual simplex method. So, in the dual simplex method, the entering variable, leaving variable, first you have to identify, it is S4, and entering variable is S2, and the pivot number is minus of 0.17. The solution, equations to find the solution for the fifth iteration, new pivot row, which is S2 row, it is current pivot row, S4 row, divided by the pivot number, which is 0, minus 0.17. And the new x2 row equal to current x2 row minus 0 into new pivot row. New x1 row equal to current x1 row minus 0.17 into new pivot row. New s1 row equal to current s1 row plus minus of minus 0.33 into new pivot row. So, using the 5 equations, finding the solution for the fifth iteration, it is here. So, z row, we have the integer solution is 5, x2 value it is 2 now, x1 value is 3, and s1 value is 2.71, and s2 value is 2. Now, the solution is optimum. So, the condition is achieved. So, the results are non-negative. S1, s2 value, x1, x2 values are non-negative. At the same time, they are x1, x2 decision variables are integers. The result are x1 equal to 3, x2 equal to 2, and z equal to 5. So, this is cutting plane algorithm. So, we find the solution by the simplex method. We find the optimum solution by the simplex method. And then, we integerize by introducing the cutting plane technique in every variable. So, finally, we will get the solution. So, for a cutting plane technique, once you reach the cutting plane technique method, so you have to use the dual simplex method. So, the student should be familiar with the simplex method as well as the dual simplex method. So, then only you can find the solution for the cutting plane algorithm. So, we stop here. So, these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering subject. You can refer to the book Operation Research for further reading and more problems in the subject. And I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the videos for your better learning. Thank you for watching. Please post your comments. You can contact me for any clarification on the subject. We'll meet again in another video with branch and bound technique. Until then, bye.